Zami football, nous comptons encore une fois avant où est côté ni là, nous dans le 4 stadium. Est-ce que m'bral dit Stéphane Guillaume c'est ancien parce que je dis à la raison que fait nous là, nous parlons dans destruction de historique stadium ça Stéphane Guillaume côté qui m'bral craser, yo pral faire une nouvelle et stadium, un stade tout neuf, c'est ça m'bral faire là Stéphane Guillaume. Alors et ou avec son plaisir en inviter Mounio Stéphane Guillaume garder comment yo pral détruire stade historique ça que même vous avez chance jouer la donne en galère destruction. Salut les spectateurs, bonsoir, bienvenue sur Haïti TV. Où est côté nous là, nous et Fort Lauderdale côté que nous avons démolition et historique stadium ça, on a parlé de Hello 4 Stadium et aujourd'hui j'ai avec moi Stéphane et aussi j'ai avec moi le meilleur et Broward County qui avait le meilleur. Comment vas-tu, ça va?
Hey, good morning.
Good morning. J'ai avec moi Stéphane aussi. Mayor, how are you doing today?
I'm doing very well. I'm the mayor of Fort Lauderdale. And my name is Dean Trentalis, and we are so thankful that we are able to partner with Inter Miami Beckham Soccer to be able to bring international soccer to our home community here.
Mayor, explain, you know, my Haitian people, all this project can be possible because we know what is the Lockhart Stadium mean for us, for our citizens in Fort Lauderdale. Today, we're gonna have a brand new team coming in, and I'm pretty sure you are the one of the guy who make this dream possible. Can you tell us all the kid
well,
possible?
There's no one person who made this happen. It was a team, my colleagues on the commission, our staff, our city manager, our city attorney, everybody, and everybody on the Beckham soccer community who we work together to make this happen. And we're hopeful that this will bring South Florida into the spotlight once again, where it's well deserved, because people should know that South Florida is the international hotspot today, and this is just one more example of how Fort Lauderdale is a partner in that endeavor.
Very good. Come on.
First off, of course, we want to thank you, not just the Haitian players or Haitian community. We want to thank you guys for bringing that opportunities to the country or the city, because this is going to be bigger than just the city in Fort Lauderdale. So you guys believe that by March, because this is going to be, you're going to take a lot of work. Do you guys believe that by March 2020?
Did you bring your hammer with you?
I don't mind. I mean,
we'll be out there.
Yeah, we'll be. Yeah. That's right. So you believe, guys, by March,
it's
you guys be ready.
It's going to happen. It will happen.
I believe in you guys. Trust me, I believe in you.
Yeah,
and we're here to support. Now, any announcement yet for player signing? Any players already signed
well,
for you guys?
I'll leave that up to the team.
Absolutely.
We're just the city.
I understand.
Yeah.
But I mean, probably they might already, you know. But you cannot make. Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. But really, we really thank you guys for doing this and allow this to happen in our city.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Mayor, one more question. In terms of economy, you think that's gonna bump up our economy?
I think it'll bring a lot of new jobs to our community. I think it'll bring a lot of interest in the in patronizing the businesses that we have here. I already know of a person who's planning to build a new hotel not too far from here. It's going to create a lot of excitement in our uptown community here in Fort Lauderdale.
Thank you so much, sir.
Very welcome.
Thank you.
Merci beaucoup.
Pas de problème. Alors, ça c'était Emilia et Fort Lauderdale qui était avec moi, avec Stéphane. Stéphane, et encore une fois, on a dit bienvenue parce que vous avez des vacances ou pas là. Et il faut me dire que c'est un excitement pour nous-mêmes comme jeunes et journalistes pour nous faire partie de gros et journée ça, une journée historique pour football ici en Sud-Floride, côté que nous pourrons gagner l'autre équipe dans MLS. Nous connaissons que nous avons Miami Fusion, nous avons toute une série d'équipes. Je dis à nous gagner et nous pourrons gagner équipe équipe des
Camdans. Here's a great Fort Lauderdale striker right here.
It is, and then we have another guest with us today. I'm going to let Stéphane present him because Stéphane, pretty know him. Stéphane.
Avant de commencer à parler avec Naptune sur son parler, but today.
Do I have to translate?
Today we are one of the broadcasters for the Fort Lauderdale Strikers, not the Strikers, but the sports in general. So we have
Bruce Silverman.
Bruce Silverman. So this guy really was not just a fan, not just a broadcaster, not just, I mean, wonderful guy. So
thank
really
you.
Happy to meet you. So how are you feeling about this project?
Now, this is really neat. This is, you know, for someone who went to his first game in 1977 against the Cosmos
right.
and Strikers,
right.
to see a renaissance and a rebirth here, it's a lot better than soccer never being played here again.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You played here.
I did.
I know. I mean, I kicked the ball around here, but you played here.
I did. And I really appreciate the fact that when I was playing, injuring, you was always there supporting me.
In fact, you were the first interview, post-game interview that we did on a Striker broadcast when you blew out your knee.
Yes. Sorry about that.
On your crutches.
Yeah.
But I actually have a picture in my office of the two of us from that game.
All right. Thank you so much. So now, what do you think? Is it going to be a good team? They're going to bring out a good team that's compete?
You know, look,
or what do you
they haven't signed a player yet.
Right.
Let's sign a player.
Right.
You know, right now I'm doing games in Orlando City.
Orlando
I'm
City.
The voice
yeah,
of Orlando
that.
City. It's a tough league. You know, we're struggling right now. We're above the Mendoza line in terms of the playoffs, but we're struggling to be consistent week in and week out. It's a 34-game season.
Right.
You know, with more teams next year, it's going to be a bigger season. And teams struggle because of the travel and everything else. This is not an easy league to play in. It is a very physical league. You know that.
Right.
North American soccer is a physical game. So it's going to be interesting. They got a lot of work to do to get ready for March.
Right.
It's a pleasure to, you know, stay next to you, Stefan, and
he's the good guy.
And exactly, used to play and the national team together and then play for Strikers. And then Stefan, you know, talked to me a lot about you. And then in turn,
and nice to meet you.
Good.
I do
thank you for everything.
Oh, my, I do play-by-play for Orlando City.
Okay.
So, but I live down here.
You have a great voice, by
Well,
way.
Thank you very
nice
much.
Nice meeting you, Woody.
Good luck.
No, you can do your
Again, amis téléspectateurs, nous avec et gros monsieur ça qui ça c'est le figure et pour et organisation ça Beckham. Jorge Mas, es un placer de tenerte con nosotros. ¿Cómo estás?
Gracias, muy bien, gracias.
No, yo no sabía si habla español, solamente
sí.
Escuché el nombre Jorge Mas. Me imagino que habla español. This channel is a Haitian channel, and then you know how Haitian is very important in for soccer, especially where you're gonna build this stadium,
yes.
Where this team gonna be.
Bueno, para mis hermanos y hermanas haitianos, es una comunidad que para mí es muy especial. Yo me crié trabajando dentro de la comunidad haitiana en nuestra empresa y para nosotros, la juventud, especialmente de la comunidad haitiana, sea en Miami o en Fort Lauderdale, les va a ser una parte muy importante de nuestra academia. So quiero que se sientan parte de este equipo. Aquí siempre van a tener su casa, la comunidad haitiana, que es muy especial para mí, porque somos isleños todos, como mi familia de herencia cubana. Pero quiero darle la bienvenida a nuestra comunidad de estar aquí, que sean parte de este proyecto y en realidad espero hacer muchas cosas increíbles juntos.
Muchas gracias, señor
gracias.
Jorge.
First, we want to thank you for
thank you.
Bringing this project into,
thank
the, into
you
our
much.
City. We really appreciate that. And so right now, by March, you guys strongly believe that the stadium will be ready.
Yes.
By March.
Yes, I strongly believe we're ready by March. You know, as I was saying earlier, the Haitian community is a community close to my heart. I began work among my Haitian friends and our entity and our family company. Recruiting and playing and players from the Haitian community are very important. Unfortunately, the pay-to-play model, in terms of how youth can become professional, in my opinion, has been the wrong model. We at Inter Miami want to make, if a young man has the ability to be able to play, we will make that dream happen. So, you know, we want you to be part of our team, part of our dream, part of our academy. So I look forward to sharing many great dreams and many visions with my friends in the Haitian
Absolutely.
Community.
Now, any player signing yet? Or?
No. We'll be announcing player signings in the next few months.
All right.
Looking forward to it.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You very much. Thank you.
Can I wear that for a second?
Yes. Yes, Inter Miami.
Inter Miami, the Haitian people.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Brazil.
Je nous d'Abidjan. Jean Dabdia would be man, so vraiment that news is very, very exciting. Moi, j'aime penser et nous allons commencer, nous allons espérer un autre projet que projet ça journée aujourd'hui. Hein. Surtout c'est David Beckham qui le sens est noir qui mène un projet ça là et meilleur là vraiment il faut que passer et tout ça. Nous dit City merci et puis nous dit monde ça vraiment venir avec projet ça. Man, bah c'est ça c'est un projet qui est incomparable.
Et Stéphane l'a dit monde ça yo et nous des gens qui sont censés en charge là et monsieur ça qui vient avec tout ce qu'on est en termes de l'argent et monsieur ça me dégaine avec nous là pour les masses et monsieur qui censé venir avec toute masse comme tout ça et tout projet ça qu'a fait là Beckham quelque part ces figures là c'est non ouais, c'est franchise c'est même qu'a vendre franchise mais en termes de l'argent pour débloquer pour faire tout ça pour faire là pour le nous gros stadium ça ici dans Fort Lauderdale c'est monsieur ça me dégaine en dans sport mag quelque part c'est son journée historique pour moi même à Rome comme jeune ouais. Journaliste et me penser que et c'est pas une journée historique pour moi même avoir comme jeune journaliste pour nous faire partie de gros projets ça nous et tout gros monde nous gagne qui avec nous là qui fait parler avec Stéphane mais vraiment je pense que le football là pral grandir ici dans Fort Lauderdale et travail nous pral grandir tout Stéphane Guillaume n'espérer que et monde Miami Inter de Miami yo et entrer nous dans projet là parce que des débuts nous commencer avec yo nous commencer dans recrutement on t'a fait avec et Timoun yo et journée jodi a été invité pour venir dans gros projet ça à côté que et qui c'est lancement projet qui commence jodi a mais vraiment Stéphane Guillaume ça me frappe ça me content pour me là pour me rencontrer toute gros personnalité ça yo et me penser que nous pral continuer essayer pour nous si nous cap mener plus monde toujours sur plateau pour nous faire parler avec c'est
pas remonter sur ça jeune ouais jodi c'est 8 mai et projet a commencé. And we nous souhaiter mars c'est le 1er mars ou bien sometime in March we're going to be back here pour nous là pour inauguration and by mon petit story to quick the Lacat stadium et puis pas oublier the Lacat stadium gain un autre stadium qui c'est baseball qui là New York Yankees te convenir like chaque spring season so Lacat stadium start in 1959 c'est là ça Lacat stadium commencé mais 1962 c'est là ça Yankees stadium côté baseball là il pas derrière qui t'a commencé en 1962. Là kounyen là ou dit on capable zo c'est pour aller dans l'autre bagaille là complètement différent parce que va gagner à peu près 7 6 à 7 terrains et va gagner 3 gros terrains de football
de premier niveau
net complètement et puis nous connaît là c'est pour aller dans l'autre stade côté que va gagner si n'a garder projet monsieur certain nous va montrer au projet pour capable projet gagner tubuleur comme si et c'est pas juste un projet pour qui temporaire c'est un projet qui va là qui pour vraiment continuer avec le travail que vous faites. Bon, vraiment, je suis content que je suis présent, ou là, au présent, vous dites, nous avons changé avec la sélection nationale là, nous avons changé avec Strikers là, côté que vraiment, ça c'est quand même moi. Et vraiment, moi vraiment excité, vraiment ému pour me regarder que je n'ai jamais dit un app là pour nous, depuis le commencement, projet ça que nous là, c'est vraiment intéressant.
C'est ça Stéphane Guillaume. Alors et les invités spectateurs encore une fois nous gagnons moi-même vous dis l'homme à Stéphane Guillaume qui de retour après ses vacances de gagner et pour gros lancement et gros projet ça équipe Beckham là et Miami Inter nous là on a petit coup de pause tout petit n'a tenu tout à l'heure.
Thank you guys for your patience. Right now we have with us Mickey.
Nikki.
We have with us now Nikki. Nikki, thank you so much for being here with us. So tell us a little bit about you, Nikki, and the position that you're going to be occupying on this.
So my name is Nikki Burlich. I'm the director of soccer operations. I'm a part of a team that oversees all of the administration, all of the roster, all of the players, staff. So it joined in January. It's a very exciting time, and I'm happy to be here.
So when you say the roster, is it going to be the youth only, or also the pro team?
So
as
the way
well?
That we all of us on the technical side have an interest in working with all levels. So whether that's the first team, the USL, the academy. So our entire staff was overseeing the ID sessions that we were operating last month for picking all of our youth players. Now we'll transition into focusing more on the USL and first team. But of course, we're starting the academy in August, and I think it's all. Of our interest to maintain oversight and involvement in the academy.
Absolutely.
Nicky, pleasure to have you in our show, Sport Mag. From Duke Gampin Moon, King Remy Shusa, Kapgadi Shusa. Even though, Nicky, you're from Canada, you're from here?
I am from Canada, yes.
You're no French? Nicky, again, it's a pleasure to have you. And then I know you've been working hard with the youth in terms of the tryout for the kids. And then tryout is over. You guys already have all the kids you guys, you know, were looking for.
Yeah.
And then explain us a little bit about the tryout, all that tryout was done.
Yeah, so I think, like I said, we had 7 full-time staff that was scouting all throughout South Florida. We tried to approach it that we would see all the players, instead of having an open tryout, that we would go and see all the players in their natural environments with their clubs, in their tournaments, in their leagues, and then pick the ones that we see, that we like, and to bring them in for an ID session. Of course, you know, this market is extremely talented. There's a wide pool of players. You know, I think that we probably got most of the players, but, you know, of course we're going to miss some of the players. So, but moving forward, I think it's something that we're going to continue to work on and scout, and we're really excited about the players that we brought in.
And I love to ask that question because, you know, in this environment where the stadium gonna be, the youth academy gonna be, it's a Haitian community. Obviously our show is a Haitian show. It's all over the world. Haitian all over the world watching this show. For my people, I know that's very important because you're very involved. Soccer is, you know, is our first sport in Haiti.
Right.
I believe they're gonna love the news. Any Haitian players part of the, you know,
yeah,
NTA
no,
Academy,
I think,
already?
I think we have several Haitian players, if I recall correctly. We have a player named Sydney Phil Zame, who's a 2002 left back. We have Carlos Geffrad, who I think is of Haitian descent.
Right.
He's a 2007, very technical, attack-minded player.
Very good player.
I believe Guy Medius is a striker, 2008, who we're really excited about, with a lot of potential. So yeah, I think coming from Toronto, coming from Canada, where we're very ethnically diverse, it's a very similar environment here. You get players from all over, different cultures, different backgrounds, and you bring them together.
That's good.
Yeah.
For the youth, you know, for whoever, for the club, for the coaches, for the, you know, 2019-2020, you know, season gonna start. Do you guys already get all the players for the youth for now? You guys keep looking for more players?
No, we'll always be looking. I think we invited 151 players to join our academy, so we'll be starting with that pool of players. Anytime we see a player that we are interested in, of course we're gonna pursue and try to always continually strengthen the academy and bring the best players from South Florida into our club.
Very good.
So is it gonna be also those young players? Are it gonna be academically as well, and also you guys gonna put them in the center where they're gonna practice or go to school in the same academy or in the center, or
everybody's gonna, come gonna to be together? So as you can see, we're gonna be in the process of building a new stadium and a new training facility that will be done approximately March. Until then, we'll find a temporary training facility to train from August until March, but the plan is to have everybody together. It's really, really important for our culture and for our club to have that pathway and for everybody to go to be able to see, visually see that path to go up to the first.
Absolutely. I'm sure those players, those kids, going to be traveling all over the world maybe, or is it going to be focused only here in the U.S.?
Well, you have your domestic league. You know, I think the U13s through the 19s are going to play in the USSDA. The U12 team is going to play in the new Florida Academy League that's been developed. But outside of that, being a part of MLS, there's going to be a lot of MLS events that we go and try and compete nationally. And we're already getting invitations to play in international tournaments. So I think there's going to be a lot of opportunities to give the players different experiences beyond just playing locally.
Nicky, thank you so much for having you, man.
Pleasure.
We appreciate it. I'm excited about this project. Looking forward to work with you guys. All right?
Thanks, guys.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Good one.
Thank you, Nicky.
Good?
Yes.
Voilà, je ne dois plus rien là où dire. C'était Nicky.
Parce que
Monsieur Balido, Monsieur Balido, explication. De point A, B, C, le follow-up with exactly ça l'a dit. Donc c'est ça qui est important parce que c'est pas mammouth. Ouais, on va le faire. Ouais, bon plan. Bon plan. Bon, c'est sûr parfois qu'on dit parole, mais n'ap suivre mais gon plan au moins gon plan que ap suivre nous excited pour nous connaître comment qui j'ai plan ça pour finir et bon hey Bido strikers is gone
but we got
how
something
do you
new
feel?
Coming I'm a little sad but I'm a little happy that we got something new coming on a little bit bigger and better days.
All right, if you guys know the hot shot. If you guys ever see the hot shot, well, this
hot
guy,
shot.
This is the guy.
The one and only.
One and only. Thank you so much, right? Voilà, Woody, man. Vraiment excited. It's fun.
C'est fun, nous faisons une pause. Nous prenons une pause tout court. Parce que nous prenons Fernando Fiore avec Fernando Fiore. Et nous connaissons qui ça, monsieur Saïe. Est-ce que je vais proposer ça? Je vais mal proposer ça même. Pas une pause. I'm just gonna receive, you know, it's a dream come true for me, Stéphane Guillaume, para tener este señor.
Conmigo.
It's a guy, you know, I watch every Sunday in Contacto Deportivo.
República Deportiva.
Cuando él tenía ese show. And it's a pleasure to have him.
Thank you.
Fernando, thank you so much for coming in. And then you did a really good job to present the entire Miami. What is that, you know, how do you feel, man, to be part of that?
How
do you feel to open this
new era, man? It's a new era. It's the future. I love Lockhart. I love the stadium. I was here so many times, and this is you know, part of my great memories, my heart, and everything. But I think it's time to move on, and now it's going to be a great future. Inter Miami looks fantastic with a great group of, you know, in the ownership, the supporters, the staff, the people around. So I think it's going to be wonderful. This is the beginning.
Fernando, I know you. I'm pretty sure you put it inside the you know, the this new organization. They're going to just, you know, finish the whole, you know, they're gonna take everything down.
It's gonna be a brand new one. You saw it in the picture.
In the picture, yes.
It's gonna be fantastic.
All right, again, thank you so much, Victor, for making yourself available for us. Well, Victor, how are you doing? What position that you're gonna be occupying this project?
So I'm in the academy staff, you know, currently assigned to the under 19 academy, and, you know, helping in collaboration to building all the academy right now.
Remember, Victor used to be my coach, and this guy, man, you don't know if he's coaching or if he's joking. So fun, make every player like comfortable. Man, I really appreciate all the help and support that you gave me throughout the years that you was coaching me.
Thank you.
And I wanted to tell you that straight up, and I really wanted to recognize you for that. So thank you.
I appreciate it.
Victor, again, for me too, is an honor. Long time friend.
Yes.
And Copa Latina. I remember the way you love Haitian players. And, you know, all the support you give us when I was, you know, playing in the Copa Latina, anywhere I go, you know, you always give me your support. Again, it's a pleasure, because sometimes we don't do those things. You know, we forgot people who help us to grow as, you know, as people, as human being. And then I cannot consider it as an interview. It's, you know, it's an honor for us today, you know, to let you know, or happy we were with you. We still, you know, with you, because for everything that you've done for us as players, man. Because sometimes people don't do those things, and then they don't recognize people who do good things for us. Today I want to thank you, man, for everything that you've done for me as a player, as a human being, man. You're a great guy, and then you're always involved in soccer. And then I know, being part of this organization is not a luck. It's for the good work you've been doing in soccer in South Florida, man. Again, thank you so much, man.
Thank you very much. You know, it's been an honor, and having had the opportunity to coach in South Florida, like you say, you know, like player from all different backgrounds, and mm-hmm. building relationships. And now with the professional club, it's different, you know, because we are going to get a support we never had, you know.
Exactly.
It's going to have a state-of-the-art facility. We're going to have a fully funded program. We're going to, you know, sort out and find ways to make sure that every kid that has talent and is worthy of an opportunity is going to have one. You know, you guys, you know, you never had this opportunity. We as a staff never had this opportunity. So I think we did good things, but it's about to get better, you know. And I really appreciate your words. You know, I always tell people, the only people that know me more than my wife and my kids are the guys that play for me. So,
exactly.
You know, it means a lot that you guys say those words. Thank you very much.
Victor, again, thank you. And then I wish you good luck. And I know you know what you're doing. And I know you're going to go far in this game. And it's your hard work you have done in the past who put you where you are today, man. And good luck, and then I wish you all the best, man. We're gonna be here behind you to support you. We used to play for you, now we're gonna support you. We support to you in the field. Now as media, we're gonna support you in the background, and then follow your good work.
Thank
and
you.
I'm pretty sure you're gonna do good. Again, man, good luck, and I wish you all the best, man.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Victor.
Jamil doing that.
Jamil.
Cioè, allora ça c'était Victor Pastore et monsieur ça qui involve en pile dans football ici dans sa Florida qui était avec et dans font pas avec nous t'a essayer et bye monsieur et remerciement pour ça le fait pour nous tant que joueur parce que me rappelle même fait venir ici dans sud Floride monsieur un monde qui supportait en pile et le m'dal fait stage dans équipe Miami FCA monsieur c'est premier monde qui ouais monsieur dit men gars un talent pur monsieur pas de gagner et pas de faire et bagaille de petits amis monsieur c'est juste son équipe qui cherche talent côté rouge côté noir côté d'Haïti côté en Espagne côté sorti en Argentine il pas trouvé ça il était ouais de talent et ça fait me arriver fait partie de gros organisation ça des questions jouer pour monsieur ça alors je dis à l'inamicom alors et amis football je pense que c'est un moment historique alors moi même personnellement moi content pour me là et je dis à dans gros festivité football ça nous ouais que nous recevoir toute gros personnalité yo c'est pas un hasard yo terelim directement pour inviter comme seul grand média haïtien parce que wap travail me pense que wap jeune fruit travail c'est parce que yo wè n'ap travail c'est parce que yo wè travail nous et à travers réseaux sociaux yo wè travail nous à travers et le monde parce que tout côté et wè chose ça wè sport mag c'est ça qui fait ba nous opportunité ça pour nous être capable venir faire et seul pour nous être capable faire couverture comme seul média haïtien dans gros et mouvement ça côté que t'a démoli et stade historique ça qui c'est Locat Stadium et qui pral faire un brand new stade Beckham et nous te recall qui masse qui des mouvement ça normalement qui pral mettre en pile cob dans city nous dans fief nous Stéphane Guillaume pour ton bel stade de premier niveau pour fanatique football pour monde qui ici et dans sud Floride Stéphane Guillaume
non seulement un stade ça pas oublier et Locat Stadium grand plein monde qui passe qui joue là dedans tant coup Wade Hudson que nous te voilà qui était là jeudi hein tu gagné Gerd Müller qui était passé dans équipe Strikers là tu gagné Pelé qui compte venir jouer là contre qui t'a joué pour New York Cosmos qui était venir jouer contre équipe Strikers là bien sûr puis gagné Jean-Philippe nous gagné Stéphane Guillaume nous gagné Jean-Marc nous gagné James Maslin donc un peu le gros monde qui gagné possibilité de jouer dans stade ça mais jeudi hein nous pas grand l'autre stade et me penser vraiment c'est en transition hein c'est en transition oui il a démoli ça là jeudi hein mais c'est pas une transition côté que vraiment et nous pas le son on l'autre visage, son l'autre atmosphère, c'est vraiment intéressant. Bon, nous allons prendre une petite pause tout court et puis nous allons retourner avec vous. Pas oublier de suivre nous sur ITTV Sportmag.
Foula!
We here with the biggest name that I know of, which is Ray Hudson. Thank you so much for having you, Ray. How are you doing?
Well, I'm doing wonderful.
Looking great, man. You're looking great.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Getting a little bit older, but this is the place I was born.
Right.
This is the place that I grew up as a footballer and as a commentator, so it's got great memories. A bittersweet day, but certainly a wonderful day for South Florida and everything that anybody that's got any passion for the game, this is a true rebirth of football with the right people and the right leadership and the right group, and it's going to be
majestic. Ray, you used to play for the Strikers. How was the experience here with the Strikers at the Lockhart Stadium?
In that stadium, the gods of the game played football. The Johan Cruyffs, the Beckenbauers, the Gerd Müllers, the Teofil Kubiyas, on and on. The best of the world played here, George Best.
Right.
You could just keep on naming names of world-class proportions that weren't just top-class footballers, were the gods of the game. And now we've got the opportunity to see what can be attracted by David Beckham's group. I imagine there'll be big names coming to this club in the eventuality that this actually gets kicked off, which it will. So it was wonderful in them days. It was the best days of my life as a player. You know, coaching was all right, it was good. And we were successful. Commentary is tremendous as well, but there's nothing like being a footballer.
Absolutely. Now, you know, the stadium's coming down, Lockhart Stadium's coming down. Are you going to work with that Miami in the team, or you don't know yet? Or are you just going to be a commentator?
No, there's no process for me being involved with the group. I have no great drive and desire. I live literally a mile away from here.
Right.
So they've got my number. If I can help in any way, I'd be more than happy.
Very happy to have you, George Best. We get George Best again. Kubiyas, you have also
Elias Figueroa.
All of the names. And here we have
Ray Hudson, we really, really appreciate what you've done in the soccer world, in sports in general. So we thank you to have you here, John.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Ray, it's a pleasure to have you.
Seeing you again, man.
And one last question before you go.
Sure.
Ray, there's a lot of people, my Haitian people is watching.
Yes.
They...
Manu Sanon.
I know.
Racine Auguste.
They hear you.
Nono Baptiste.
They hear you all the time, Ray.
Yes.
Very quick, very quick. I know your time is very precious.
Okay.
For my people who love to, you know, when you do your play-by-play, they love to
they
watch
love
you.
The
especially in Barcelona, Madrid.
Of course.
Can you tell my people a little bit who is Ray Hudson? They know they hear the name all the time, but the first time my people see, but they don't know who you are.
Sure.
Can you explain my people very quick who is Ray Hudson?
Of course, I played for Newcastle United as a young player, and that's when I came over here to the United States to get on loan, just because the NASL was exploding. The great Arsene Auguste Pelau was part of the whole setup as well. Had some really class Haitian players in them days. What's the name of the great central defender? I was a wonderful player. It'll come back to me. But Manu Sanon, of course, and the names that there'll be a lot of wonderful. The Haitian fans would come here, and I hope. I know that was the golden generation of Haiti.
Right,
that was the golden generation,
true,
and that was very special. But every time there's a game on and the Haitian people arrive, they bring with them a party atmosphere and an appreciation of the game.
Right.
I remember seeing West Germany against Colombia at the Orange Bowl, and there was a big turnout of the Haitian community, and they were the best. They're the people I want to sit with watching a game. Not the others.
Yeah.
If you're with the Haitian group, I'm not kissing the ass or anything like that. It's the truth. They love the game as much as anybody, if not more than anybody in the world. And it's been too long since they've been able to say with pride what a national team. Let's hope we can, find another one. Franz Mathieu. I knew I'd get it. Franz Mathieu, what a player.
Ray Hudson, and I cannot let you go we have to talk a little bit about that. Barcelona, Liverpool.
Yes.
The first game, Barcelona went 3-0. The second game, 4-0. Did you think about that?
Yeah, I was watching the game, staggering beyond belief, but it was the beauty of football. That's what it's all about. Who would have thought without Firmino and without Mohamed Salah that Liverpool could come back from 3-0 down against the greatest footballer in the world for me, Lionel Messi, and Barcelona. It was staggering to watch it develop, but it's football, and that's why it'll never be anything less than the greatest game in the world. Anything can happen, and no matter what anybody says, I don't know football. You don't know football. Nobody knows her. And she can turn that incredible mirror and say, you don't know me, because look what I can do. Liverpool were magnificent. And the fans, again, like those Haitian fans that I was talking about, that's what ignited this team. That was the fuel under them. The fire that burned under Anfield propelled Liverpool onto a great victory. Terrible night for Barcelona. Terrible. Poor Jordi Alba. I've never seen him play
that bad. Ever.
Incredible. And Suarez was wrapped up by Van Dijk nicely. But it's all excuses. The best team won.
Absolutely. Do you think Valverde is still gonna, gone?
I hope so. Because I've been saying it all year long. I really don't think he's brought the fearlessness out of Barcelona. He's very pragmatic, and it's won his two. He could win two doubles, but for Barcelona standards of fearlessness and being more aggressive when they've got leads. Remember, they lost the 4-0 at PSG. They lost 3-0 at Juventus. On and on. These were big games where he became a little bit more defensive. So I think it's time, and I hope it's the Ajax coach. I hope it's Ten Hag, because the way his team play with that bravery, that's what we want to see at Barcelona.
Ray, thank you so much. It's a pleasure.
You're very welcome,
man. It's a dream come true.
It's always great talking to you guys.
To stay next to you, Ray. I'm very happy. I'm speechless. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Anytime.
Hey, Grand Ray, thank you so much for making yourself available too.
All right.
I appreciate it. Pablo, you have suivi nous sur Haiti
TV, c'est show préféré là, show d'amour pour la qui c'est Sport Mag. Moi-même, Stéphane Guillaume, on dit l'homme à nous là, tu peux dans le 4 stadium pour nous venir porter Jean et transition en fait, la démolition en fait dans le 4 stadium. Vraiment, je dis, c'est un jour inoubliable, c'est un jour que nous ne pouvons jamais capable de dire, comme son histoire, mais quand même, nous contents pour nous être là, pour nous être présents, pour nous avec tout le monde, ça y est, qui vraiment dans l'organisation, moins David Beckham, of course, mais quand même, he's going to be here for sure in March.
And we will get him.
Absolutely, we'll absolutely. Donc, nous avons commencé, pas oublier, vous pouvez suivre nous sur ITTV, c'est show préféré qui c'est Sport Mag. Vous dites, moi, c'est vraiment, c'était un moment inoubliable, son moment. Quand on va aller au jeune Réel, c'est facile comme ça. Ou pas, quand on va aller au jeune Réel, c'est comme ça. Pour jeune monsieur, ça
oui. Fernando Fiore.
Fernando Fiore. Nous aimons comme demain. Golazo, Winalda! Winalda, Winalda! World, world, world!
Et from the que Stéphane Guillaume senti me flatter et this is the beauty of the game. This is the beauty of what we're doing. And Steph, nous pas d'accord ça c'est une contente comme ça pour nous remercier le directeur de la télévision, appelé Claude Mancuso, pour tout sacrifice que monsieur fait. En his way, machine monsieur bloqué avec et chauffé, monsieur Bajam fâché, monsieur Baba, monsieur parqué machine dans la rue. Monsieur dit, vous dites, l'homme, viens chercher pour nous faire ça, viens en réalité pour Fanatic Football, pour Haïtien en général qui chita la caillou, qui pral vivre le moment ça, Stéphane Guillaume. Alors parfois, mounio chita. Yo jwenn bay la vin jwenn ni vin jwenn yo pa comprendre ki apli sacrifice ki fait c'est ça fait moi même pa comprendre comment pour un moun pa vle sponsoriser ça comment pour un moun pa vle vin aider nous Stéphane Guillaume pour nous grandir étant que jeune garçon qui aime le football haïtien qui t'a aimé ouais média nous non l'autre niveau Stéphane Guillaume parce que quelque part on va voter tête on va faire ventard nous vle mettre média et moun ka parler football non l'autre niveau parce que ouais kounya ou commencer garder non l'autre gens parce que yo relèm spécialement pour yo faire vinn là c'est pour un hasard grand pile l'autre média mais yo choisi nous même parce que n'a travaillé Stéphane Guillaume nous pas jamais bon goût nous pas jamais touche un goût mais nous toujours là Stéphane Guillaume nous toujours pas être dans télévision bien belle c'est pas comme nous gain c'est fort c'est parce que nous respecter Fanatic Football c'est parce que nous respecter haïtien qui vient toujours là Stéphane Guillaume mais vraiment men et m'a dit tête moins courage. Et Stéphane Guillaume, on a continué le travail, on a goûté jusqu'à ce que nous jouions, ça nous besoin. Parce que nous pensons que nous avons talent, nous besoin de mettre et sport nous à notre niveau, nous besoin de parler football dans l'autre gens, nous parler de faire dans gens terre à terre, nous besoin de faire dans gens, Riot Son, tout le toute valeur, je vous dis, amen. Nous pensons que nous avons travaillé, nous avons joué un résultat quand même.
Voilà, je l'ai absolument, tu es dans la 4e. La 4e, la première fois que tu es touché la 4e, c'était en 1998. Deuxième fois que tu as tiré nos velis, c'était en 2015. Époque, nous rappelons, Ronaldo est venu prendre l'équipe Strikers là. Mais je ne dis à nous en 2019, c'est pour censé yon l'autre era qui va commencer avec la 4 stadium. Pas oublier Miami, Inter Miami, qui va jouer dans MLS pendant deux premières saisons, qui va jouer là d'abord, et puis yon compter pour descendre Miami pour yon jouer, pour yon continuer à jouer. Mais quand même, yon toujours considéré la 4 stadium pour gagner peut-être yon équipe USL qui va venir jouer la dernière. Mais quand même, c'est pour quand même équipe Miami United lancer pour la Cali quand même, si toutefois yon a besoin de match, yon a toujours retourné la vie jouer. Donc, l'autre fois encore, c'était Sport Mag, ou t'as suivi sur ITTV, non pas M. Stéphane Guillaume, nous avons dit, bien sûr, nous connaissons et directeur de télévision, Claude Mancuso, mon cher, courage, nous disons merci parce que vous avez une opportunité, vous avez une image, vous avez une télévision pour nous faire ça nous voulons, hein, ça nous voulons, c'est nous pour connaître qui j'ai pour nous gérer, seulement depuis nous sommes professionnels dans ce que nous avons fait, mon cher, nous vraiment apprécions. Merci à Claude Mancuso, pas oublier, nous dit quand même merci avec Guy Elik qui est là avec nous, nous et Daniel qui est toujours nous supporte, et nous avons qui j'ai l'autre partenaire de Mancuso, ça fait que vous venez, ça fait que Ken, nous connaissons et tout le monde qui est toujours venu là, qui est toujours dans nos supports. Donc, quand même, nous venons nous merci. Et tout ça qu'a fait là, nous participons là, nous contribuons dans ce qu'a fait là. L'autre fois, non pas M. Stéphane Guillaume, nous venons avec nous aujourd'hui. C'était Sport Mag, vous suivez nous sur ITTV. Pas oublier, suivez nous sur channel ITTV YouTube, nous, qui est Sport Mag. Pas oublier, pour abonner, mettez comment. Posez des questions et puis là pour nous répondre.
Et sponsor aussi, Stéphane Guillaume,
bon, tout le monde. Sponsor, il y a des bagages, il y a des laines. Pas oublier, ma amie là. Donc, on va décider. En tout cas, nous disons merci d'avance parce que vous avez beau venir. Salut tout le monde. Oula!